Good morning. Good morning. So happy to be with you all here this morning. I'm not sure if Denise actually said exactly what Sarah said she said, but let us pray if she did. But no, seriously, I'm really excited to be here and share with you. What I'd like to do is give you a very high-level update on where we are. So about a few weeks ago, we had our annual meeting. We do it once a year. And the goal was to, you know, talk about what's been achieved since the last year. So I'd like to share that with you. But one of the things that we've been having conversations about is around extending the school year and making learning continuous, so that year-round school calendar. And in those meetings, what we heard was we need more information about successful programs other places, what this looks like. And so I'd like to be able to, and you guys are actually the first that will hear this, to be able to share that with you today, some of those statistics that show the success of extending time for school. These aren't apples to apple comparisons because every program is different, but be able to share that with you and then open it up for questions. So where are we? So when Denise was here last year, I was actually here at the presentation, you know, she told you that year one was a planning year for Project Lift. And so she spent the year really evaluating what Project Lift would look like and put together a strategic plan. So this is our first full year of implementation in the schools. During that planning year, they formalized a partnership with CMS that basically made Project Lift a zone. So there are 9 schools that fall under Project Lift, and these are all schools that feed into West Charlotte. So West Charlotte is the high school, and then there are 9 schools that feed into that. And I kind of break it up into corridors. So there's, you know, the Northwest Corridor where we have West Charlotte and Bruns. There's Freedom Drive where we have Allenbrook, Thomasboro, and Ashley Park. And then Statesville Road, where we have Walter G. Byers, Drew Hills, Ranson, and Statesville Avenue. So those are our schools. And so with that, she started hiring staff. And so in this last year, there are about 9 of us over in a zone office that was graciously donated by the city. It used to be an old code enforcement office. I've been here for my whole life, so I remember when it was a library. And wondering how in the world that functioned as a library, because the space is extremely small. So our zone office is there on the corner at 2324 LaSalle Street. So that's, you know, been the extent of where we were and how we've come to be. And so what are we doing every day over there in that zone office? We have also established partnerships with 21 funders. And so what you'll see is, what you have is a list of all of our grant endorsed partners. And you'll see a description of what the organization is about, the school that they're operating in, and, you know, how people contact that program or enroll in that program. So our partners do everything from making sure that our operation is running right. So you'll see, not necessarily on this list, but we have the Larry King Center, we have UVA that we're working with, and there's one other, I can't think of what it is, but those are like operational partners. So they come into the schools and they say, this is what you're doing well, this is where you need improvement. So every 3 months, UVA comes to us and they walk through our program. Our staff went to UVA in July, August of this year, and got training on how to operate turnaround school programs. So the, yes, sir.
What is UVA and what is the Larry King Center?
The University of Virginia.
Okay.
And the Larry King Center is an organization that basically monitors and your processes and procedures to see if what you're doing makes sense. They make sure that we have sign-in sheets for meetings. They make sure that the analysis that we're doing is actually making sense, that we're going to, in the end, we'll be able to deliver the results. So those are operational type partners. So they come in and they are basically like our audit system, if that makes sense. So they kind of audit us to make sure that operationally we're doing what we need to do. But then our other partners actually work in the schools, and that's what you have here. So we're working with them to deliver after school programming for and tutoring for our students. We're working with them. I'm really excited about two of the technology partners that we have, Charlotte's Web at Johnson C. Smith, and also there's the NASCAR STEM project, which I'm really, really excited about because it's working with West Charlotte students. They actually, it's a math, science, and technology program where they're building a race car. And so everything that goes, and they actually build the car. And so they have to earn the right to actually work on the car. So the math and science that goes into that is what they're learning, and they're competing on a national level with that program. And then we have communities and schools, which is in primarily all of our schools, Men Who Care Global, Right Moves for Youth, and YDI. So also, one of the things that Denise did as a part of Project LIFT is to create the LIFT Academy. And what the LIFT Academy is an extensive program for students who need lots of credits to graduate. Like, there's one student that's 19 and has 4 credits. And so they have pulled those students out of general population. They actually, these students have said, I'm dropping out, and we got them to come back. They've been going to school since the summertime, and they're actually aggressively working toward getting their credit. So they, some of them actually go to school 12 hours a day because they're also taking classes at Hawthorne. They take classes during the day at West Charlotte, and they, between night school and day school, they're doing credit recovery at West Charlotte. So they're in school for 12 hours trying to make up those credits so that they can graduate on time. And eventually the LIFT Academy will have its own home in a building off of Dr. Carter Boulevard. And so the goal for the LIFT Academy is to really work in a small setting. There are only about 56 students in the LIFT Academy. So the goal is to bring, to have them in a small setting, work with them. And so YDI, which is Youth Development Initiative, they actually work with those students. They do after school tutoring with them. They bring in speakers. They do job and career readiness programs with them. And so the goal of the LIFT Academy is really to, whatever those students want to do at the end, once they get that diploma, whatever they want to do, they'll be prepared to do that. So that's year one. We have actually formally implemented in the schools. We are working aggressively with our partners to be able to deliver support services for the students. And we're, you know, monitoring and tracking our progress as we go along. So the next thing that you have in your chair is a calendar. And so what that is the proposal for extended year-round schools. So there are several strategies that operate around Project LIFT. One of them is time, and it's how we manage time that we have with the students to make sure that they're getting a quality education. So from that, you know, one of the challenges is closing the achievement gap and still having 12 weeks of summer. So that the loss, the learning loss that happens over the summer, we're trying to combat that with this program. And so what we're looking at is 20 additional days added on to the school year to make it now 200 school days and making that learning continuous. So there would be not 1 month during the year where students would not be in school. So they'd be in school all year long.